Hi, this is Dr. Vijay. Today we are going to learn active site of an enzyme. What is active site? It is a region or area or part of an enzyme, and it is a small area. So enzyme is a macromolecule. It is a big molecule when compared to substrate. So within the enzyme there is a small area or region that is called active site of an enzyme. So this small area looks like a cavity. With the X-ray diffraction study reveals that the active site of an enzyme looks like a cavity or a pocket. What is the role of this active site? So this is a region where substrate binds. Could be one substrate or more than one substrate. So they will bind to this region, that is active site. This region is comprising of specific amino acid residues. We know that enzymes are proteins. So protein means they have definite amino acid sequence, and they have primary structure, secondary structure and tertiary structure. So because of this folding with the specific amino acid residues, they will form a cavity or a pocket in an enzyme molecule, and that region with the specific definite function is called active site of an enzyme. Usually this active site is made up of 10 to 15 amino acids. So this is an enzyme. So this region is called active site of an enzyme where substrate binds. It could be one substrate or more than one substrate. And this active site is usually made up of 10 to 15 amino acids. This active site has got, or this amino acid residues can be divided into two types. One is binding residues, or those amino acid which has got binding activity. We can call it as binding site, and the residues are binding residues. And among these 10 to 15 amino acids, few amino acid actually catalyzes the reaction. So that is called catalytic site. So usually the catalytic site comprising of 2 to 4 amino acids. So when substrate binding site of the active site of an enzyme, and it creates a chemical environment so that this catalytic site can make conformational change so that there will be catalysis. The active site is a region where reaction occurs. So when the substrate binds to binding site of the active site of an enzyme, it makes a chemical environment for catalysis. So catalytic site or catalytic residues of active site actually speed up the reaction by decreasing activation energy. So this binding of substrate to the enzyme induces transition state of the substrate. So here the force that attract the substrate to the active site is maybe physical, or it might be chemical. So usually the amino acid residues in the active sites are non-polar or sometimes hydrophobic. It may not be true in all active sites. So these chemical forces might be electrostatic, ionic or van der Waals forces, or hydrophobic bond or hydrogen bond. So the polarity, the charge or hydrogen bond, electrostatic bond, or van der Waals forces, these forces attract substrate to the enzyme. And the chemical environment created by when substrate bind to the binding site of the active site of an enzyme, so they will induce a conformational change in the enzyme so that the catalytic site or catalytic residues, they are nothing but amino acids, they actually makes a enzymatic reaction by decreasing the activation energy required for that particular reaction. This catalysis depends upon many environmental factors like temperature, pH, even concentration of enzyme and substrate. So every enzyme has got their own optimum temperature and pH. So we'll discuss when we discuss factors affecting enzyme activity. So active site has got two types of amino acid residues. One where substrate binds, it is called binding site. This binding site actually binds and orient substrate or substrates. Whereas catalytic site actually catalyzes the reaction by decreasing activation energy. So this binding of substrate to enzyme is a non-covalent bond, like hydrogen bond, electrostatic bond, ionic bond, or van der Waals forces, or sometimes hydrophobic interaction. Cofactors also helps in binding of substrate to the binding residues of active site of an enzyme. The active site of an enzyme is specific to its own substrate, and this can be explained by lock and key model or induced fit model. So any modification in the amino acid sequence in the active site will alter the enzyme activity. So that is again the reason for mutation or many disease, because these amino acid, 10 to 15 amino acid sequence within the polypeptide of entire enzyme, they have a definite and specific function. Any alteration or modification might be due to mutation, then it alters the enzyme activity, or in other words, it affects enzyme activity, or it cannot catalyze the reaction. The amino acid sequence in the active sites are very important for catalysis. This is about active site of an enzyme. Thanks for watching.